Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Arabic ebook before it's gone.
Welcome to ArabicPod101.com's Al Arabiya fi Thalathi Daqa'iq, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Arabic. Marhaban, ana Carol, sururtu bilika'ika. Hi, I'm Carol, nice to meet you. In this series, Al Arabiya fi Thalathi Daqa'iq, we're going to learn basic Arabic expressions. It's super easy and it takes only 3 minutes. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to introduce yourself in Arabic. There are a few other ways to say it, depending on how formal you want to be. Let's first look at an informal way to introduce yourself in Arabic. Marhaban, ana Carol, sururtu bilika'ika. Hi, I'm Carol, it's a pleasure to meet you. Marhaban, ana Carol, sururtu bilika'ika. Now you try it. Start by saying marhaban, which is the equivalent of hi. Then say ana, literally I am, followed by your name. Ana Carol is I am Carol. Finally, say nice to meet you. If you're talking to a man, you say sururtu bilika'ika. If you are talking to a woman, say sururtu bilika'iki. This phrase means pleasure to meet you. In the English phrase pleasure to meet you, you is a neutral word. You can use it for both men and women. But in Arabic, the word you needs a gender. When you change the last letter in lika'ika, a, to an e sound, lika'iki, you are actually changing the word you from the male to the female version. Please be careful to use the correct version. Now let's see another way of introducing yourself. In this version, you will say, hi, my name is Carol, instead of, hi, I am Carol. And we will learn another way of saying, nice to meet you. Marhaban, ismi Carol. Tasharraftu bima'rifatika. Hi, my name is Carol. I am honored to meet you. Marhaban, ismi Carol. تشرفت بمعرفتك. What has changed from the previous introduction? Let's take a close look at these together. First, مرحباً, أنا كارول, has changed to مرحباً, اسمي كارول. So, instead of saying, hi, I am Carol, we are speaking in a more formal way by saying, hi, my name is Carol. Next, after giving your name, instead of saying, سررت بلقائك, you say, تشرفت بمعرفتك. Or I am honored to meet you, which is a bit more formal. Again, we should not forget to change the ending of the word depending on the gender of the person you're speaking to. It would be تشرفتُ بمعرفتك for a man and تشرفتُ بمعرفتك in case of a woman. One more time, here are the four ways you learn to introduce yourself in Arabic. Informally, مرحباً, أنا كارول, سررتُ بلقائك if you are speaking to a man. And marhaban ana Carol sururtu bilika'iki if you are speaking to a woman. The formal way to introduce yourself is marhaban ismi Carol tasharraftu bima'rifatika if the person you're talking to is a man. And marhaban ismi Carol tasharraftu bima'rifatiki if that person is a woman. Now it's time for Carol's tips. When you introduce yourself in the Middle East or Northern African countries, it's polite to offer your right hand for a handshake or give 3 kisses on the cheeks, although the rules vary depending on where you are. Arab people place great value on politeness. So, for example, it is considered rude to enter a room or a place without greeting everyone. If you use the right sentence to introduce yourself, they'll definitely be impressed. Do you know how to say thank you in Arabic? You will learn how to say this and many other words in the next lesson. نراكم في المرة القادمة. See you next time.
In this video, you will learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Arabic. Hi everybody, my name is Nora. Welcome to the 800 Core Arabic Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Arabic. But there is a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we will include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at ArabicPod101.com, Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally, master Arabic. Okay, let's get started. First is مقلاه, frying pan. مقلاه, مقلاه, frying pan. هذه المقلاة رخيصة جدا. This frying pan is very cheap. هذه المقلاة رخيصة جدا. لوح تقطيع, cutting board. لوح تقطيع, لوح تقطيع, cutting board. الطاهي يقطع بيضة مسلوقة على لوح التقطيع. The cook is cutting a hard-boiled egg on the cutting board. الطاهي يقطع بيضة مسلوقة على لوح التقطيع. حوض, sink. حوض, حوض, sink. الحوض يكاد أن يكون ممتلئاً. The sink is almost full. الحوض يكاد أن يكون ممتلئاً. صحن عميق, bowl. صحن عميق, صحن عميق, bowl. الصحن العميق فارغ. The bowl is empty. الصحن العميق فارغ. مخرج, exit. مخرج, مخرج, exit. أين المخرج؟ Where is the exit? أين المخرج؟ خريطة, map. خريطة, خريطة, map. تحقق من الخريطة لتعرف الطريق إلى وجهتك. Check the map to find your way to your destination. تحقق من الخريطة لتعرف الطريق إلى وجهتك. حقيبة سفر, suitcase. حقيبة سفر, حقيبة سفر, suitcase. لا تترك الأشياء الثمينة في حقيبة سفرك. Do not leave valuables in your suitcase. لا تترك الأشياء الثمينة في حقيبة سفرك. سائح, tourist. سائح, سائح, tourist. أنا سائح أيضا. I'm a tourist too. أنا سائح أيضا. السياسة, politics. السياسة, السياسة, politics. أكتب مدونة عن السياسة والاقتصاد. I blog about politics and the economy. أكتب مدونة عن السياسة والاقتصاد. علم الأحياء, biology. علم الأحياء, علم الأحياء, biology. علم الأحياء هو علم دراسة الكائنات الحية. Biology is the study of living organisms. علم الأحياء هو علم دراسة الكائنات الحية. الكيمياء, chemistry. الكيمياء, الكيمياء, chemistry. المختبر مكان ندرس فيه عن الكيمياء. The laboratory is a place to learn about chemistry. المختبر مكان ندرس فيه عن الكيمياء. الفيزياء, physics. الفيزياء, الفيزياء, physics. أعرف قواعد الفيزياء. I know the basics of physics. أعرف قواعد الفيزياء. علم الاقتصاد, economics. علم الاقتصاد, علم الاقتصاد Economics. يعد علم الاقتصاد خلفية جيدة للعديد من المجالات. Economics is a good background for many fields. يعد علم الاقتصاد خلفية جيدة للعديد من المجالات. وضع put وضع وضع put. ظننت أنني وضعت المفاتيح على الطاولة. I thought I put the keys on the table. ظننت أنني وضعت المفاتيح على الطاولة. تذكر remember. تذكر تذكر remember. تذكرت المرأة الرقم. The woman remembered the number. تذكرت المرأة الرقم. أمسك بي hold. أمسك بي أمسك بي hold. أمسك بيدي كي نعبر الشارع. Hold my hand to cross the street. أمسك بيدي كي نعبر الشارع. عربة المشتريات shopping cart. عربة المشتريات عربة المشتريات shopping cart. عربة المشتريات فارغة. The shopping cart is empty. عربة المشتريات فارغة. حقيبة بلاستيكية plastic bag. حقيبة بلاستيكية حقيبة بلاستيكية plastic bag. يحمل الرجل حقيبة بلاستيكية مليئة بالمشتريات. The man is carrying a plastic bag full of groceries. يحمل الرجل حقيبة بلاستيكية مليئة بالمشتريات. كوميديا comedy. كوميديا كوميديا كوميدي. إنهم يشاهدون الكوميديا ويضحكون. They are watching a comedy and laughing. إنهم يشاهدون الكوميديا ويضحكون. رواية novel. رواية رواية novel. أريد أن أقرأ رواية تشويقية. I want to read a suspense novel. أريد أن أقرأ رواية تشويقية.
Well done! In this lesson, you've expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at ArabicPod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You will also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time. Salam.
Hi everyone, I'm Gabriella. How are your Arabic listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
المرأة تسأل موظف المتجر عن شيء في متجر الكتب. أي كتاب تريد المرأة أن ترى؟ عذراً، أود أن ألقي نظرة على الكتاب الذي فوق الرف.
أي كتاب فيهم؟
الذي يتكلم عن السيارات.
لحظة من فضلك، هذا هو؟
نعم، هذا هو.
تفضلي.
أي كتاب تريد المرأة أن ترى؟ المرأة تسأل موظف المتجر عن شيء في متجر الكتب. أي كتاب تريد المرأة أن ترى؟ عذراً، أود أن ألقي نظرة على الكتاب الذي فوق الرف.
أي كتاب فيهم؟
الذي يتكلم عن السيارات.
لحظة من فضلك، هذا هو؟
نعم، هذا هو.
تفضلي.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Arabic listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
امرأة ورجل ينظران إلى قائمة الطعام في المطعم. ماذا سوف يطلب الرجل؟
ماذا سوف تطلبين؟
البيتزا تبدو لذيذة. أعتقد أنني سوف أطلبها.
لقد تناولت البيتزا أمس، لذلك.
حسناً، ما رأيك بالهامبرجر؟
هذا يبدو جيداً، سوف أطلبه.
ماذا سوف يطلب الرجل؟ امرأة ورجل ينظران إلى قائمة الطعام في المطعم. ماذا سوف يطلب الرجل؟
ماذا سوف تطلبين؟
البيتزا تبدو لذيذة. أعتقد أنني سوف أطلبها.
لقد تناولت البيتزا أمس، لذلك.
حسناً، ما رأيك بالهامبرجر؟
هذا يبدو جيداً، سوف أطلبه.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Arabic listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
رجل يتصل بعيادة الطبيب. في أي وقت عليه أن يكون في عيادة الطبيب؟ مرحباً، كيف أستطيع مساعدتك؟
في أي وقت تغلقون اليوم؟
نحن نغلق في الساعة 6:00، ولكن هل يمكنك المجيء قبل 5:30 لو سمحت؟
حسناً، شكراً.
في أي وقت عليه أن يكون في عيادة الطبيب؟ رجل يتصل بعيادة الطبيب. في أي وقت عليه أن يكون في عيادة الطبيب؟ مرحباً، كيف أستطيع مساعدتك؟
في أي وقت تغلقون اليوم؟
نحن نغلق في الساعة 6:00، ولكن هل يمكنك المجيء قبل 5:30 لو سمحت؟
حسناً، شكراً.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Arabic listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
طفل يقرأ يومياته. ما هو أول شيء فعله الطفل اليوم؟
الجو كان جميلاً. ذهبت للسباحة عصراً في المسبح، وذهبت لمشاهدة فيلم في المساء، ودرست طول النهار. اليوم لم يكن سيئاً.
ما هو أول شيء فعله الطفل اليوم؟ طفل يقرأ يومياته. ما هو أول شيء فعله الطفل اليوم؟
الجو كان جميلاً. ذهبت للسباحة عصراً في المسبح، وذهبت لمشاهدة فيلم في المساء، ودرست طول النهار. اليوم لم يكن سيئاً.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Arabic listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
رجل وامرأة ينظرون إلى صورة. إلى أي صورة ينظرون؟ هذه الصورة لفريق كرة القدم الذي يوجد فيه ابنك، أليس كذلك؟ أي واحد فيهم هو ابنك؟
هذا هو.
إنه أطول واحد.
نعم، إنه حتى أطول مني.
إلى أي صورة ينظرون؟ رجل وامرأة ينظرون إلى صورة. إلى أي صورة ينظرون؟ هذه الصورة لفريق كرة القدم الذي يوجد فيه ابنك، أليس كذلك؟ أي واحد فيهم هو ابنك؟
هذا هو.
إنه أطول واحد.
نعم، إنه حتى أطول مني.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time.
مرحباً، أنا كارول. Hi, I'm Carol. Welcome to ArabicPod101.com's العربية في 30 دقائق. The fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Arabic. In the last lesson, we learned how to introduce ourselves in Arabic. Today, we're going to learn how to use good manners as we thank people. هل أنتم جاهزون? Are you ready? فلنبدأ. Then let's start. There are several ways to thank someone. Let's start with the most common phrase, شكراً. شكراً. شكراً means thank you. To say thank you very much, you just need to add جزيلاً. شكراً جزيلاً. شكراً جزيلاً. شكراً is a formal way of saying thank you. If you want to thank someone more casually, say متشكر if you're a man and متشكرة if you're a woman. متشكر. متشكرة. This phrase means I am grateful or I am thankful. When someone thanks you, how should you answer? There's no set response like you're welcome in English, but there are a few things you can say. The first is بكل سرور. This means with pleasure. بكل سرور. Another phrase you can say is تحت أمرك, which literally means at your service or at your disposal. If you're talking to a woman, you should say تحت أمرك. تحت أمرك. تحت أمرك. It is often used as a funny way of responding to someone thanking you. There are so many ways of saying you're welcome in Arabic. Another one is لا شكر على واجب, which means don't thank me, it's my duty. لا شكر على واجب. Now it's time for Carol's tips. شكراً can mean thank you or thanks. Arabic language is very emotional, and relations between Arab people are very personal. So what if you want to use an expression that sounds more friendly? In that case, you can use Allah يخليك. This is a nice way to thank someone. That means, may God protect you. Do you know what إلى اللقاء means? In our next lesson, you learn this, and more greetings in Arabic. إلى اللقاء في المرة القادمة. مرحبا، أنا كارول. Hi, I'm Carol. Welcome back to ArabicPod101.com's العربية في 30 دقائق, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Arabic. In the last lesson, we learned how to thank people by saying شكراً and شكراً جزيلاً. In this lesson, we learned some of the most common greetings used in Arabic-speaking countries. هل أنتم جاهزون? Are you ready? فلنبدأ, then let's start. The most common greeting is مرحباً or hi. مرحباً. This is a general way to greet people when you see them. A more cultural greeting is Assalamu alaikum. This means peace be with you and is generally used only by Muslims. We say it when we meet someone and also when we leave. Assalamu alaikum. Someone could respond to Assalamu alaikum with marhaban or hi, but it is more polite to respond to such greetings in the corresponding way. Since Assalamu alaikum means peace be with you, when greeted in that way, we should answer back with Wa alaikum assalam, which literally means peace be with you too. Wa alaikum assalam. Whether you use marhaban, hi, or assalamu alaikum, it is also polite to ask the person how they are. Kayfa haluka? How are you? Kayfa haluka? Don't forget that in Arabic, the word you needs to have a gender. So, kayfa haluka is good if you are talking to a man, but if you are talking to a woman, you should ask kayfa haluki? Kayfa haluki? When it's time to leave, you can say wada'an or goodbye. Wada'an. The other person can reply ma'a salama, which means be safe. Ma'a salama. Let's review the phrases you've learned in this lesson. Marhaban is hi. Assalamu alaykum is peace be with you. The response is wa alaykum assalam. Kayfa haluka or kayfa haluki is how are you. Wada'an is goodbye. And ma'a salama is be safe. Now it's time for Carol's tips. If you're leaving and you want to show the person that you would like to see them again, you can use إِلَى اللِّقَاءِ, meaning see you, or إِلَى اللِّقَاءِ قَرِيبًا, see you soon. إِلَى اللِّقَاءِ, إِلَى اللِّقَاءِ قَرِيبًا. Now you know lots of ways to greet people in Arabic. During the next lesson, we learn the meaning of the phrase هَلْ تَتَكَلَّمُ الْإِنْجْلِزِيَةِ? Do you already know it? I'll be waiting to talk about it with you in the next Al Arabiya fi Thalathi Daqa'iq lesson. Ila liqa'i qariban! Marhaban jami'an, ana Carol. Hi everybody, I'm Carol. Welcome to ArabicPod101.com's Al Arabiya fi Thalathi Daqa'iq, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Arabic. In the last lesson, we learned the most common forms of greetings in Arabic. Do you remember them? We introduced Marhaban and Assalamu alaikum, as well as Shukran and Ila al-liqa. In this lesson, we're going to learn a very useful phrase. Do you speak English? If you find yourself in a situation where you need assistance in English, this phrase can be a lifesaver. And because you're asking it in Arabic, you can be sure that everyone will understand what you're saying, even if their answer is no. Are you ready? Then let's start. Here's the basic way to ask if someone speaks English. هل تتكلم الإنجليزية? If you are talking to a male. And هل تتكلمين الإنجليزية? If you are talking to a female. هل تتكلم الإنجليزية؟ هل تتكلمين الإنجليزية؟ هل means do. You and speak are merged in the same word تتكلم for males and تتكلمين for females. إنجليزية means English. This is an indirect way of asking someone to speak to you in English. There are many ways of making it clear that you're asking the person to speak English to you. For example, هل بإمكانك التكلم بالإنجليزية? Means, could you speak English? هل بإمكانك means, could you? Are you able to? Or, is it possible to? And is referring to the ability of the person to speak English. Again, if you're talking to a female, you should change the last accent of ك to كي. So the question becomes, هل بإمكانك التكلم بالإنجليزية? التكلم means speaking. and بالإنجليزية is in English. To be more formal, we could add the word please to the request to make it هل بإمكانك التكلم بالإنجليزية من فضلك؟ In this case, the question cannot mean the person's ability to speak English anymore, because you are obviously asking them to speak English to you. Since in Arabic, the word please literally means from your favor, it should also be changed according to the person's gender. So, in case of a female, we should also change the ka ending of please in min fadlika to min fadliki. The question becomes, هل بإمكانك التكلم بالإنجليزية من فضلك؟ The responses you will receive could be one of these three. نعم, yes. نعم. قليلاً, a little. قليلاً. There are a few ways of saying no in Arabic. لا or كلا. No, I don't speak English. Is لا, أنا لا أتكلم الإنجليزية. لا, أنا لا أتكلم الإنجليزية. It is exactly the same structure as in English. لا is no. أنا is I. لا means don't. أتكلم is I speak. And الإنجليزية is English. Since this last one is a negative statement, we need to say لا before the verb أتكلم or speak. لا literally means no, but when placed before a verb, it negates this verb, becoming don't or doesn't. Notice also that the verb أتكلم is slightly different than تتكلم, which we learned before. Remember, the verb changes depending on the pronoun used. We are not talking about أنا, Arabic for I. Thus, I do not speak is أنا لا أتكلم. Now it's time for Carol's tips. For those of you who are not native English speakers, you can obviously use this question with any language you need. Arab people study other languages at school, depending on the country they live in, so maybe you'll get lucky. Just substitute الإنجليزية with الفرنسية for French, الإيطالية for Italian, الإسبانية for Spanish, or الألمانية for German. In this lesson, you learned how to ask if someone can speak English. In the next lesson, we'll learn how to say, excuse me, and other ways to apologize in Arabic. I'll see you in the next العربية في ثلاث دقائق lesson. إلى اللقاء! مرحباً, أنا كارول. Hi everybody, I'm Carol. Welcome to ArabicPod101.com's العربية في ثلاث دقائق, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Arabic. In the last lesson, we learned the phrases هل تتكلم الإنجليزية؟ Do you speak English? And هل بإمكانك التكلم بالإنجليزية؟ Could you speak English? And we mentioned the word من فضلك, which means please in Arabic. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to use المعذرة or عفواً and أنا آسف and other words when apologizing in Arabic. We should use المعذرة or عفواً when we want to say excuse me, such as when we are ordering something in a bar or a restaurant. For example, المعذرة قهوة من فضلك or عفواً قهوة من فضلك. Excuse me, a coffee please. We can also use it when asking a question. المعذرة, أين المحطة? Or, عفواً, أين المحطة? Excuse me, where is the station? Sometimes we also hear people say, من فضلك, or please, to draw somebody's attention. من فضلك. If the person is a woman, we replace the ending with كي, so it becomes من فضلك. In case you want to use excuse me to apologize instead of asking something, you should say عذراً. It can be used if you accidentally bump into someone on the street. عذراً. Just like عذراً, we can use أنا آسف when apologizing. It literally means I'm sorry or pardon me. As we learned in the last lesson, أنا means I, So the adjective that follows should be modified according to the gender. So if you're a woman, you should say أنا آسفة instead of أنا آسف. All of these phrases can be used for either excuse me or I'm sorry. But if you really want to apologize for something, it might be better to use a different phrase. That phrase is the verb سامحني. سامحني. It can be translated as forgive me in English. It is a bit stronger, but it can be used in both formal and informal situations. Again, since سامحني means that you are asking for the other person's forgiveness, it should be changed according to the gender. So it becomes سامحيني if the other person is a female. سامحيني. Now it's time for Carol's tips. Please remember that in most of the Arab countries, if you accidentally bump into someone, you don't say forgive me, سامحني, which is for a more serious annoyance. Instead, we say عذرا or أنا آسف, excuse me or I am sorry. Are you able to count in Arabic? In the next lesson, we will learn the digits in Arabic from 1 to 9. I'll be waiting for you in our next العربية في ثلاث دقائق lesson. إلى اللقاء في المرة القادمة.
Most people who learn a foreign language learn it so that they can one day have real-life conversations with native speakers. When you start out learning and crack open your first textbook or listen to your first podcast, having a real conversation can feel like a fantasy. When everything about a language feels new, it can be overwhelming. But this couldn't be further from the truth. While it does take a significant amount of time and effort to become fluent, having a conversation might not be as far off as you think. In this video, we'll look at three ways you can boost your conversational skills and start talking to native speakers. Number one, find native speakers and practice with them. It's unlikely you live near a big group of native speakers to practice with. If you happen to be in a major or international city, your chances may be better. Check and see if your city has a general language exchange. Chances are there could be a native speaker there who is also trying to learn another language. Practicing in person with a native speaker is probably the most interesting option for honing your speaking skills. But if you can't find anyone where you live, the next best option is to look online. Luckily for language learners, the past 10 years or so have seen an explosion in online language exchange sites. On these websites, you can search for someone who is a native speaker of your target language and is also learning your native language. The idea behind a language exchange is that you communicate with them via video or text chat, and half of the time, they help you practice your target language. And for the other half, you help them practice theirs. Practicing via an online language exchange is a highly effective way to practice your conversational skills. Number two, work on pronunciation. Pronunciation is often an overlooked skill when it comes to learning a foreign language. Most people think of a good foreign accent as a luxury rather than a necessity. But what most people don't talk about is how having a good accent boosts your listening and comprehension skills. If you can hear a sound from a foreign language and know how to make it yourself, then you're more likely to understand native speakers when they talk at normal speed, and you're also more likely to remember any new words or phrases you come across. Having a good accent means that the language no longer sounds foreign. Instead, it sounds familiar, maybe even natural. So, how do you go about perfecting your accent? The best way is to break down the language into its individual sounds. Make note of any sounds that are the same or similar to your native language and of those that are different. Of the sounds that are different, spend your time practicing the ones that you find the hardest to say correctly. After you're comfortable with the individual sounds, you can start linking together words and phrases. This is where accent practice starts to get really fun and interesting. Get your hands on some native speaker audio from a TV show, song, or podcast. Play the audio back and listen closely a few times. Take note of how words blend together in speech. Then, do your best to imitate what you hear, trying to match the speaker's emphasis and intonation. Our language learning program's playback feature is perfect for this. Record yourself and compare it to the original recording. Rinse and repeat until you're comfortable with the audio selection, and then move on to something more difficult. This is how you can break through the accent barrier and really start to make the language your own. Number three, learn phrases, not just individual words. Learning grammar and individual words is great, but it's not the only approach you should take if you want to speak fluently. In addition to your regular grammar and vocabulary, try learning whole phrases, even if you aren't totally sure how they work grammatically. Learn phrases that are specific to your needs. It's a good idea to learn phrases that are grouped around a certain setting or subject, such as simple greetings or introductions, questions for getting to know someone, or traveling comfortably. You can even learn filler phrases, which you can use so that you have something to say when, well, you don't know what to say. Learning phrases like this will help you become conversational faster. You may not understand what you're saying literally, but as long as you know the general meaning behind the phrase and know when to use it, you'll be able to talk like a native. Eventually, your knowledge of grammar and vocabulary should catch up with the phrases you know. Learning a new language should feel like an adventure. There will be plateaus and periods in your learning where it feels like you're hitting a wall, but being able to speak with native speakers and have real conversations will help you combat language fatigue. After all, talking to someone face-to-face in a foreign language is one of the main reasons we start learning in the first place. And for even more ways to gain conversation skills, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hi everyone, my name is Prihan and this is Arabic Top Words. Today's topic is 10 phrases to amaze native speakers. So let's get started. أقدر أحفظ حوالي 50 كلمة عربي جديدة في اليوم. I can memorize around 50 new Arabic words a day. The first phrase is أقدر أحفظ حوالي 50 كلمة عربي جديدة في اليوم. I can memorize around 50 new Arabic words a day. أقدر أحفظ حوالي 50 كلمة. It's too long. Even I cannot memorize it. That sounds tough. Good luck. أقدر أتابع أفلام عربي من غير ترجمة. I can watch Arabic movies without subtitles. The next one is أقدر أتابع أفلام عربي من غير ترجمة. I can watch Arabic movies without subtitles. I think it's amazing to watch Arabic movies without subtitles because as you all know, Arabic has a standard Arabic and dialect Arabic and they're so different. So usually all movies are made in the dialect. So if you can listen to the dialect and understand so well without the subtitles, that means that you're very, very good at Arabic. Yeah. أنا بتعلم عربي لوحدي. I'm learning Arabic all by myself. أنا بتعلم عربي لوحدي. I'm learning Arabic all by myself. And this is amazing because Arabic is very difficult. So if you decide to learn it all by yourself, then you're a very smart person. All by myself. أنا فهمت كل اللي أنت قلته. I completely understood everything you said. أنا فهمت كل اللي أنت قلته. I completely understood everything you said. If you can understand native speakers without missing anything out, then you're doing a great job, I suppose. أنا أخذت سنة واحدة بس لغاية ما بقيت بتكلم بطلاقة. It took me only 1 year to become fluent. أنا أخذت سنة واحدة بس لغاية ما بقيت أتكلم بطلاقة. It took me only 1 year to become fluent. And this is amazing, and you can only achieve that by having lots of Egyptian friends you can speak with every day. So you can easily learn Egyptian Arabic fluently. You can speak it fluently in only 1 year or even less. العربي ممتع وسهل في التعليم. Arabic is fun and easy to learn. العربي ممتع وسهل في التعليم. Arabic is fun and easy to learn. And of course, Arabic is fun and easy to learn if you're doing it with us, Arabic Pod 101. أنا مش بس بعرف عربي. أنا بتكلم شوية لغات تانية برضو. Apart from knowing Arabic, I can speak a few other languages as well. أنا مش بس بعرف أتكلم عربي، ده أنا بعرف كمان أتكلم شوية لغات تانية. Apart from knowing Arabic, I can also speak a few other languages as well. For example, English. شكرا ليك، بس هي في الحقيقة مش لغتي الأم. Thank you, but it's not my native language actually. شكرا ليك، بس هي في الحقيقة مش لغتي الأم. Thank you, but it's not actually my native language. أنا بعرف أتكلم عربي بأكتر من لهجة. I can speak Arabic in more than one dialect. أنا بعرف أتكلم عربي بأكتر من لهجة. I can speak Arabic in more than one dialect. For example, I can say شاكو ماكو حبيبي. It means how are you or what's up, my love or حبيبي in Iraqi dialect.
أنا بعرف أقرأ عربي كمان. I can also read Arabic. The next phrase is أنا كمان بعرف أقرأ عربي. I can also read Arabic. And if you would like to practice Arabic more, you will most certainly find your favorite books in Arabic translated. And that's it for today. What was your favorite phrase? Can you write it below in the comments? Don't forget to subscribe and comment and visit our website, ArabicPod101.com. Bye-bye.
In this video, you will learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Arabic. Hi everybody, my name is Nora and welcome to the 800 Core Arabic Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Arabic. But there is a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at ArabicPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard decks, and finally master Arabic. Okay, let's get started. First is الموز, banana. الموز, الموز, banana. أريد 8 كيلوغرامات من الموز. I want 8 kilos of bananas. أريد 8 كيلوغرامات من الموز. تفاح, apple. تفاح, تفاح, apple. أريد زجاجة عصير تفاح لو سمحت. I want a bottle of apple juice, please. أريد زجاجة عصير تفاح لو سمحت. العنب, grape. العنب, العنب, grape. هذا العنب يبدو قديما جدا. That grape looks pretty old. هذا العنب يبدو قديما جدا. بطيخ, watermelon. بطيخ, بطيخ, watermelon. الوطاويت متدلية من غصن تأكل بطيخ. The bats are hanging from a branch eating watermelon. الوطاويت متدلية من غصن تأكل بطيخ. عصفور, bird. عصفور, عصفور, bird. أخبرتني العصفورة. A little bird told me. أخبرتني العصفورة. فأر, mouse. فأر, فأر, mouse. الفأر يأكل عنبة. The mouse is eating a grape. الفأر يأكل عنبة. الشمس, sun. الشمس, الشمس, sun. الشمس تشرق في الشرق. The sun rises in the east. الشمس تشرق في الشرق. الجو, weather. الجو, الجو, weather. إن الجو جميل اليوم. It is nice weather today. إن الجو جميل اليوم. درجة مئوية, degree. درجة مئوية, درجة مئوية, degree. هي بالكاد درجة مئوية واحدة. It is barely one degree outside. هي بالكاد درجة مئوية واحدة. مرأة, woman. مرأة, مرأة, woman. مرأة تشرب كوبا من القهوة. A woman is drinking a cup of coffee. مرأة تشرب
كوبا من القهوة. رجل man رجل رجل man. الرجل أحب المرأة. The man loved the woman. الرجل أحب المرأة. حبيبة girlfriend. حبيبة حبيبة girlfriend. حبيبة تتكلم العربية. An Arabic speaking girlfriend. حبيبة تتكلم العربية. حبيب boyfriend. حبيب حبيب boyfriend. أكره التسوق مع حبيبي. إنه كثير التدقيق. I hate to go shopping with my boyfriend. He's so picky. أكره التسوق مع حبيبي. إنه كثير التدقيق. قطار train. قطار قطار train. القطار وسيلة آمنة للمواصلات عادة. Trains are usually a safe means of transportation. القطار وسيلة آمنة للمواصلات عادة. طائرة airplane. طائرة طائرة airplane. الركاب مسافرون على الطائرة. The passengers fly on the airplane. الركاب مسافرون على الطائرة. أوتوبيس bus. أوتوبيس أوتوبيس bus. هل يذهب هذا الأوتوبيس إلى رمسيس؟ Does this bus go to Ramses? هل يذهب هذا الأوتوبيس إلى رمسيس؟ تاكسي 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 تاكسي. ركبت تاكسي. I rode a taxi. ركبت تاكسي. السبانخ spinach. السبانخ السبانخ spinach. السبانخ صحية لجسدك. Spinach makes your body healthy. السبانخ صحية لجسدك. دولفين dolphin. دولفين دولفين dolphin. الدولفين يسبح في المحيط. The dolphin is swimming in the ocean. الدولفين يسبح في المحيط. حبار squid. حبار حبار squid. الحبار يسبح بالقرب من الشعاب المرجانية. The squid are swimming near the coral reef. الحبار يسبح بالقرب من الشعاب المرجانية. Well done! In this lesson, you've expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at ArabicPod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time. Salam.
Today we're going to talk about four techniques to help you stop translating in your head and instead start thinking in your target language. This will allow you to have conversations with ease, read smoothly, and better understand native speakers. These are four methods to help you think in a new language. Number one, surround yourself with your target language. This way, you'll be completely immersed in the language. Without realizing it, you'll learn pronunciation, sentence structures, grammar, and new vocabulary. Play music in the background while you're cooking, or have a radio station on while you study. Just use one of our endless podcasts available to you. These are easy to listen to in the background while doing other things. Number two, learn through observation. This is how we all learned our native languages as kids. Words will develop their own meanings that relate better to your target language, rather than meanings that are translated directly. Number three, speak out loud to yourself. Even if you're a little embarrassed, it forces you to listen to how you speak. It makes it much easier to spot simple grammar mistakes. Number four, practice daily. If you practice everything for only one day, you won't retain the information you learned. The brain can realistically only focus for about 30 minutes. So studying a little every day allows you to absorb better. Follow these steps and have patience. You'll soon be able to achieve your language learning goals. Just make sure to remember these four methods. Sign up for your free lifetime account. No credit card required, and you'll get the best free online resources. And start learning more every day. Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Arabic ebook before it's gone.